Today we will discuss about the facial muscles of the face. Muscles of the face. There are so many muscles are situated on the lateral and medial or dorsal aspect of the face that are responsible for the facial expression, for the purpose of the mastication, for the purpose of the prehension of the food, for the purpose of the vision. So there are so many muscles are present on the facial regions. What are that muscles? We will discuss the one by one. So first, if you will see the muscles of the face, muscles of the lips and the cheek region, I told you in the lip region you will get only main major muscles, that is the orbicularis oris. If you will see the lip, that is the lip is mainly formed by the orbicularis oris muscles. I told you this orbicularis oris muscles is situated between the mucous membrane and the skin, between the mucous membrane and the skin. Likewise, some other muscles like levator nasolabialis, levator labii superioris properius, dilator nasalis lateralis, these are the name of the muscles. Depressor labii superioris, zygomaticus, incisivus superior and the inferior, buccinator, and the depressor labii inferioris. Depressor labii inferioris. So we will see the one by one. First is the orbicularis oris. I told you this orbicularis oris is from the lip. So this muscles is situated around the rima oris. I told you rima oris, that is the opening of the or external opening of the oral cavity, that is the rima oris. So this orbicularis oris form the upper and the lower lip. But this muscles is not complete. I told you here is the muscle. So this muscles is goes like this. So it gives incomplete ring. So this orbicularis muscles is like this, from here to here and up to here. That muscles is not completed because at the level of the muscle, this orbicularis oris muscles is not there. So I told you previously also the muscles is situated in between the skin and the mucous membrane. It blends with the all muscles of the face, which convert to the angle of the mouth. This is the angle of the mouth. So at this level, all muscles of the face is converged along with the orbicularis oris. If you will see the action of these muscles, so these muscles play important role in the to close the lip and help in the suction and the mastication. So these muscles help in the sucking and the mastication, and also to close the both lip. You see here this one. You see this picture. This is orbicularis oris. This is orbicularis oris. It goes like this up to here. This region there is no orbicularis oris here. Orbicularis oris. Another muscles, that is levator nasolabialis. Levator nasolabialis. This one. This levator nasolabialis, you see this one. This is levator nasolabialis. You see this broader one, this one. This is levator nasolabialis, this A part. And here you see one A dash is there. So this one is the A dash, is the deep part of the levator nasolabialis. And here is the superior part of these muscles, levator nasolabialis. So levator nasolabialis has two part. What are those? Superficial and the deep part. Superficial part and the deep part. So levator nasolabialis muscles has two part, that is the superficial and the deep. So it is thin muscles and continuous above with the frontalis. You see these muscles is goes continuous on the frontal region. On the frontal region, that is the frontalis muscle. So it these muscles is goes cranially downward and the forward in direction. downward and the forward in direction. So the muscle's fiber is goes obliquely downward and forward in direction. I told you it has two parts, superficial part and the deep part. Between these superficial and deep part, between these superficial and deep part, levator labii superioris propriis and the dilator nares lateralis muscles is the passes. You see, I told you this one is the superficial part, this one is the deep part. Between these two part, between these two part, these muscles are the passes. These muscles is the passes. This is the dilator nares lateralis and the this one is the superior oblique propriis muscles. Levator labii superioris propriis muscles. This one. Here you see levator labii superioris propriis and the dilator nares lateralis. This name indicating dilator laris nares lateralis. And another one is the levator labii superioris propriis. So these two muscles are passes between the superficial and the deep part. Now superficial part you see, superficial part, this one, this superficial part is the somewhat larger than the deep part. Superficial part is the larger and the deep part is the smaller. Deep division is the small. So in case of the buffalo, this deep division is the absent. Deep division is the absent. So between these two, levator labii superioris propriis and the dilator nares lateralis. You see this one. This one is the levator labii superioris propriis. This muscles is the levator labii superioris propriis. And here this B1. And here this one is the dilator nares lateralis. Dilator nares lateralis. This one. These two muscles are passes in between the superficial and the deep division of the levator nasolabialis. Okay. So origin of these muscles, levator nasolabialis, is the frontal and the nasal bone. So these two muscles are arises from the frontal and the nasal bone. And it inserted into the upper lip. Its insertion is the upper lip. And its action, what is the role of these muscles? To elevate the upper lip and the dilate the nostril. To elevate the upper lip and the dilate to the nostril. Here you see very clearly this one. This one, levator nasolabialis. This is the levator nasolabialis. This is the very wide and the thin muscles, levator nasolabialis. This one. Now you see this, the levator labii superioris propriis. Levator labii superioris propriis. This one. Here. You see this one. This is the levator nasolabialis. And here in between these two, you see very thin three bundles is there. Three bundles are there. This one. So this is the levator labii superioris propriis. This is the levator labii superioris propriis. Between these two, I told you two muscles, that is the levator labii superioris propriis. So this is a narrow band like muscles placed between the levator labii superioris propriis and the depressor labii superioris propriis. Okay, this one. Levator labii superioris propriis is the first one and the second one is the dilator nares lateralis. So between the superficial and the deep division, you will find levator labii superioris propriis and the dilator nares lateralis. So this labii superioris muscles has a flat narrow muscles passing between the superficial and the deep layer. I told you this, its origin is the facial tuberosity. Its origin is the facial tuberosity. I told you the facial tuberosity at these places. So this muscles is arises from this level. So its origin is the facial tuberosity. Its origin is the facial tuberosity. And its insertion is the wing of the nostril. Here is the nostril. So it inserted into the nostril. What is the action? Action is the to elevate the upper lip. Action is the to elevate the upper lip. To elevate the upper lip. And its insertion is the by several minute tendons in the upper lip. So levator labii. You see the name. You see the name, then you can remember really easily. Levator labii superioris propyrius. Superioris labii means the lip. Superioris means the upper part, and propyrius means the proper. So this muscles is inserted into the upper lip because its name indicating levator labii superioris propyrius. Second one is the dilator neris lateralis. So its name indicating it help in the dilate to the nostril. Dilator neris lateralis dilate the nostril, and it's situated in the lateral aspect. That's why its name is lateral. So this is narrow band like stuff muscles. You see this one is the levator labii superioris propyrius, and you see this one, this is just below the levator labii superioris. Another muscles is the dilator neris lateralis. This one, this is dilator neris lateralis. So I told you this placed between the levator labii superioris propyrius and the depressor labii superioris propyrius. So its origin is also facial tuberosity. It is also originated from the facial tuberosity. Its insertion is the lateral wing of the nostril. Lateral wing of the nostril, and its help in the dilate the nostril. I told you it help in the dilate the nostril. Another is the depressor labii superioris propyrius. Here this one is also terminate into the upper lip, that is the superioris propyrius. That's why here is the depressor. It's help in the depression. It's help in the depression means it help in the close or compress. It help in the close or compress the upper lip. Levator means that help in the open. So levator, if the term is arises from the levator, it means it help in the open something. And depressor labii, it means it help in the to close the lip. So depressor labii superioris propyrius, name indicating itself everything. Depressor means it close, labii means lip, superioris means upper, and propyrius means the proper. So these muscles, depressor labii superioris is a thick fusiform muscles just dorsal to the buccinator. Just dorsal to the buccinator. Where is the buccinator? This one. Here. This is the buccinator. This is the buccinator. You see, this is the buccinator. You see one another important muscles here. Very clearly, this is the zygomaticus. This is the zygomaticus. Band-like structures. This is the zygomaticus. And we are talking about this one. This is the depressor labii superioris propyrius. You see here three band-like muscles. First one is the levator labii superioris. Second one is the dilator neris lateralis. And the third one is the depressor labii superioris. Depressor labii superioris. Okay. So depressor labii superioris. This depressor labii superioris is also arises from the facial tuberosity. So all muscles, that is the depressor labii, levator labii, and the dilator neris lateralis, all three muscles are arises from the facial tuberosity. All three are arises from facial tuberosity. So insertion in the muscle and the upper lip by several branches of the tendon. Its action is the to compress the lip or to close the lip. Close the proper lip, upper lip. Now, next is the zygomaticus. You see this one. This is the very clear. This muscles is the zygomaticus. This is the zygomaticus. So, as the name indicating, this zygomaticus is long strip shaped muscles, and it passes over the masseter and the buccinator. It passes over the masseter and the buccinator and insert to the angle of the mouth. Insert to the angle of the mouth. You see, it arises from the here. Zygomatic process of the malar bone, and it goes into the angle of the mouth. So this is the zygomaticus. This is the zygomaticus muscles. Now its origin, I told you, zygomatic process of the malar bone. Its insertion is inserted into the buccinator orbicularis or is at the angle of the mouth. Its action to retract and raise the angle of the mouth. So this zygomaticus muscles is the important. Here also you see this one. This is the zygomaticus. This is very clearly visible. Zygomaticus. It arises from the zygomatic process of the mylar bone. Now next is the incisiva superior and incisiva inferior. Name indicating that is the mandible or the body of the mandible of the upper aspect and the lower aspect. So it consists the in the superior incisiva muscles. It consists an indefinite group of the muscles. So there are so many muscles fiber. It originated from the anterior lateral angle of the premaxilla and inserted into the deep face of the upper lip. And what is the action? So its action is to pull the lip towards the premaxilla. So its action is pull the lip towards the maxilla. Sorry, premaxilla. Likewise, another inferior incisiva inferior muscle situated in the lower lip. Origin, the body of the mandible, it arises from the body of the mandible at the level of the second incisor teeth. It arises or originated from the body of the mandible at the level of the second incisor teeth. Insertion is the lower lip. It inserted into the lower lip and its action is to elevate the chin. Now next is the very important muscles, that is the buccinator. Where is the buccinator muscles? This one. This is the buccinator muscles. You see, this is the buccinator muscles. Yeah, this is the buccinator. Buccinator, I told you in the cheek classes also. So these buccinator muscles form the cheek or the lateral wall of cheek or lateral wall of the oral cavity. So these muscles lies on the lateral wall of the mouth below the below and deep to the zygomaticus. So its posterior part is deeper to the masseter. I told you just behind this here is the masseter muscles. So these muscles goes on the ventral to the masseter muscles. So its posterior part is the deeper to the masseter. So what is the origin? So origin of this buccinator muscles is the alveolar border of the mandible and the maxilla. So these muscles arises from the here, and here it cover from this area also. So it arises from the alveolar border of the maxilla and the alveolar border of mandible also. So its insertion in the angle of mouth, blending with the orbicularis. Its action is that it help in the flat of the cheek, press the foot between the teeth and also retract the angle of the mouth. It press the foot between the teeth for the mastication purpose and it helps to the flatten the cheek. So another muscles, that is the depressor labii inferioris. So name indicating depressor labii inferioris means it is the concern with the lower lip. So this muscles is here. You see here. Depressor labii inferioris. Here. This one. This is the depressor labii inferioris. Just ventral to the buccinator. Just below the buccinator muscles. So this muscles lies along the inferior border of the buccinator. And it's posteriorly almost goes along with the buccinator, but in the anterior part it becomes separated from the buccinator muscles. Its origin is the alveolar border of the mandible behind the last cheek tooth, and its insertion is the lower lip, and its action to depress the lower lip as the name indicating depressor labii inferioris. So next is the muscles of the mastication. What are the different muscles that help in the mastication? There are so many muscles that help in the mastication. That is the masseter, temporalis, pterygoideus medialis, pterygoideus lateralis, and digesticus. So first of all, see, these muscles are situated at which place? I told you masseter muscles. This masseter muscles is situated on the lateral aspect of the posterior part of the ramus of the mandible. I told you this mandible has the horizontal part and the vertical part. So on the vertical part, or you can say on the posterior aspect of the horizontal ramus, on the lateral aspect, that very large rounded muscles is there, that is the masseter muscles here. This is the major chief muscles of the mastication. If anybody will ask you the muscles that is the chiefly involved in the mastication, that is the masseter. Masseter is the chiefly involved in the mastication. So masseter is the chief masticatory muscles. So this is the position of the masseter muscles. So this masseter muscles is the large powerful muscles situated on the lateral aspect of the vertical ramus. Its origin, it arises from the zygomatic arch, facial crest and the facial tuberosity. Zygomatic arch, facial crest and the facial tuberosity. Here is the facial tuberosity, here is the zygomatic arch. So it arises from the zygomatic arch, facial tuberosity and the facial crest also. So its insertion in the lateral face of the posterior border of the vertical part of the ramus. So it inserts into the posterior border of the vertical ramus of the mandible. Its action to close the jaw and the move the mandible forward and upward, acting singly to produce the lateral motion for the purpose of mastication. Another muscles is the temporalis muscles. I told you in case of the skull, just on the base of the horn, you will get some depression just medial to the paramastoid process. One space is deep fossa like structure is there, that is the temporal fossa. This temporal fossa is generally filled with the fat. If you will remove all the fat, then you will found the temporalis muscles. And just in front of these fossa, there is temporomandibular articulation is there. Temporomandibular articulation is there because this temporal bone and the condyloid process of the mandible is articulate at this place. So its origin of the temporalis muscles is the rough part of the temporal fossa. So its insertion is the coronoid process of mandible. I told you this mandible is articulate with the temporal bone, and form the temporomandibular articulation. So this temporalis muscles arises from the temporal fossa and insert into the coronoid process of mandible. And it help in the raise the lower jaw. Another is the pterygoideus medialis. Name indicating it's on the medial side. I told you the pterygoid bone. If you will see the ventral aspect of the skull, just behind the palatine bone. You remember the palatine bone, the vertical part of the palatine bone, or the perpendicular part of the palatine bone. There is pterygoid bone is there. So this pterygoideus medialis is situated on the medial side of the vertical ramus. Just opposite to the masseter muscles. Masseter muscles is situated on the lateral side, and just opposite to the masseter muscles on the medial face, pterygoideus medialis is there. You see here, this is the sagittal section of the skull. You see this one, these muscles. This is the pterygoideus medialis. This is the medial side of the mandible. Because this is the sagittal section, lateral side is the outer side, here is the medial side. So this is the pterygoideus medialis. You remember, just opposite to the masseter muscles on the medial side. Masseter muscles on the lateral side and the pterygoideus medialis on the medial aspect of the vertical ramus of mandible. Okay. Now, another this one, this muscles is originated from the perpendicular part of the palatine bone, pterygoid crest, and the pterygoid process of the sphenoid, post-sphenoid bone also. Its insertion in the medial face of the vertical ramus of the mandible. Its help in the to raise the lower jaw, to raise the lower jaw, and acting singly to assist the lateral movement of the jaw, lateral movement of the jaw. Another muscle is the pterygoideus lateralis. So this pterygoideus lateralis is the very small muscles and situated just dorsal to the this one. This is the pterygoideus medialis. So this is the pterygoideus medialis. Here is the pterygoideus lateralis. So this pterygoideus lateralis muscles is situated just dorsal to the pterygoideus medialis. Just dorsal to the pterygoideus medialis. So pterygoideus medialis is the small muscles and lies on the upper part of the pterygoideus medialis. Its origin is the posterior border of the pterygoid process of the sphenoid bone. Its insertion is the medial part of the anterior border of condyle and the adjacent part of the neck of the mandible and also the temporomandibular joint. Its action is to draw the jaw forwards and acting singly to move it in the opposite side also. So this is the pterygoideus medialis and the pterygoideus lateralis and the buccinator muscles. All these muscles are involved in the mastication. Another important muscles, this is the very important muscles in the mastication purpose, two important muscles. First is the masseter, another one is the digesticus muscles. This is the very important muscle, digesticus, name indicating di means it has the two end. Digesticus muscles, name indicating di means two end in. These muscles have the two end. It is a long muscle extending from the paramastoid process. You remember the paramastoid process? Paramastoid process to the medial face of the horizontal ramus. You remember the paramastoid process in the occipital bone? So this muscle arises from the medial face of the paramastoid process and to the medial face of the horizontal ramus. It presents two muscular valleys. I told you it has the two muscular valleys, that is the anterior and posterior valley. So this anterior and posterior valley is united with a tendon between them, that is the intermediate tendon. This is the only muscles that have the intermediate tendon. You also remember for the objective person which muscles have the intermediate tendon. So these muscles have the intermediate tendon. Its origin is the paramastoid process. You see where is the digesticus muscles? You see here. You see this one. This one. This is the digesticus muscles. This one arises from the paramastoid process. It goes like this and up to here. Up to here. Yes. This is the digest. You see the first valley. This is the first valley of the digesticus muscles, or you can say the posterior valley of the digesticus muscles. Here is the anterior valley of the digesticus muscles. You see between these anterior and posterior valley, some signing type of structures is there. This one. This one is the intermediate tendon. I highlighted here. This one is the intermediate tendon. So this one is the anterior and posterior valley of the digesticus muscles. And these muscles is also situated on the medial side of the mandible. Medial side of the mandible arises from the paramastoid process and inserted into the vertical ramus, medial surface of the vertical ramus and below and behind the mandibular foramen and goes up to the body of the mandible also. So these muscles, you remember, I can give you in short note on the digesticus muscles. So these muscles have the intermediate tendon. It has the two valley, anterior valley and the posterior valley. Between these two valley, there are intermediate tendon is present. Now next very important thing, that is the muscles of the tongue. There are two type of the muscles in the tongue, that is the intrinsic muscles and the extrinsic muscles. There are extensive movement in the tongue with the presence of these two muscles, that is the extrinsic muscles and the intrinsic muscles. So intrinsic muscles present on the dorsal aspect of the tongue, and its fiber is runs in the longitudinally, transversally, and the vertically also in the three direction, that is the longitudinally, transversally, and the vertically also, and it has no attachment with the hyoid apparatus. Because this is the intrinsic, so there is no attachment with the hyoid apparatus. So it has the intrinsic and extrinsic muscles. So if you will see the extrinsic muscles have the three muscles, that is the styloglossus, hyoglossus, and the genioglossus. Now styloglossus, if you will see the styloglossus, it is a long and thin muscles and situated on the ventral lateral aspect of the face. Origin is the lateral surface of the great cornu or stylohyoid of the hyoid bone, and its insertion in the tip of the tongue. You see the styloglossus muscle. This is styloglossus muscles. Here you see that this is the dorsal part of the tongue. This dorsal part of the tongue is made up of the intrinsic muscles. Here is the extrinsic muscles, three extrinsic muscles, that is the styloglossus, genioglossus, and the hyoglossus. So this styloglossus arises from the stylohyoid, and it goes onto the tip of the tongue. Another is the hyoglossus. It is a broad flat muscles situated on the lateral side. You see this one. This is the hyoglossus muscles arises from the lateral part of the root of the tongue, and it inserted into the root and the body of the tongue. Another muscles is the genioglossus muscles. This genioglossus muscles is a very wide and the fan like structure muscles. These muscles arises from the medial face of the ramus of the mandible, and just behind the symphysis, that is the mandibular symphysis, and inserted into the upward and the backward towards the posterior part of the tongue, middle part of the tongue, and also the apex of the tongue. It means this genioglossus muscles, you see here, this is the genioglossus muscle. This is the genioglossus muscles. It arises from the ear, near the mandibular symphysis, and it inserted into the tip of the tongue, body of the tongue, and also goes to the root of the tongue also. So this is the genioglossus muscles, origin from the mandibular symphysis and goes on the all part of the tongue. And the hyoglossus muscles, this arises from the root of the tongue, and it goes to the root of the tongue and the body of the tongue. And styloglossus, it arises from the stylohyoid of the hyoid bone, and goes laterally towards the tip of the tongue. So this hyoglossus, genioglossus, and the styloglossus, all three muscles are the extrinsic muscles of the tongue. So this is all about the muscles of the tongue and the face. Okay. Do you have any question? So today evening classes we will start from the 2:00.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay, because after three.